when you have a bag of money to spend for a computer, then you can buy the most powerful computer in the universe. But when you are in a budget for your dream computer, then it is quite hard to decide what to buy. In this video, I will show my journey to build an ultimate gaming and editing PC within my budget, and I believe that will help you to make your own decision. This video is sponsored by Altium Designer, which is a US-based PCB design software company. It has modern features like curved routing, HDI support, and it can even design rigid flex PCBs. No matter how complex your design is, Altium has you covered. So start your free trial from today. Link has given in the video description. Computer can be used for different purposes. Many people use it for general purpose, some for gaming, and some uses for editing purposes. For every different purpose, we need different configuration. For general use, we don't need a very good processor or a high-end graphics card. But for video editing, especially in Adobe Premiere Pro, we definitely need a good processor. And with it, a low-end graphics card works fine. Whereas for gaming purpose, we mainly need a high-end graphics card. And with it, a mid-range processor. But as in my case, I need a computer for both video editing and gaming. So I have no other option than to buy the processor and graphics card from high-end segment. Now the main thing is budget. Depending on that, I need to choose all the items. My budget is around 2 lakh in Indian rupees, which is around 2700 in US dollar. Then I search the internet that which item will be suitable for my requirement according to my budget. For the processor, I chose AMD Ryzen 7 3800X, and for the graphics card, I chose RTX 2070 Super, which can handle every modern games very smoothly. Then I added the rest of the items into the shopping cart. My budget was 2 lakh rupees, but the price was little more than that. That was okay, but the sad thing was, after a few hours, the price of the processor increased. Then I thought, why shouldn't I compare it with local shops? So I went to local computer shops and took price quote from at least 4 to 5 shops. And I was really surprised to see the price difference compared to online. Also, I got different price quote in different shops for the same item. If I buy each item from the cheapest shop, the difference was more than 14 to 15,000 rupees. Within which I can easily upgrade the processor to Ryzen 9 3900X, which is much more powerful than the 3800X, even better than top-end Intel processor. And the good thing is, even with 3900X, I also saved more than 2000 rupees. So it's always a good practice to check the price offline before buying it from online. There are all the items that I have bought. Now it's time to install them one by one. First, I took out the motherboard from its box and placed it on a table. After that, I opened the processor box and took out the processor gently and aligned the processor gold mark with motherboard's mark and locked it. Next, I took the RAM and inserted them into the memory slots. After that, I inserted the SSD into the PCIe socket and attached the heatsink. Now it's time to bring up the cabinet. First, I pulled the cabinet out from its box and kept the tempered glass at a safe place. Then I placed the motherboard into its position and secured it with screws. The processor comes with stock cooler, but I didn't like it because of how it looks, and it is not efficient compared to liquid cooler. So I used this liquid cooler from Deepcool. First, I installed the pump over the CPU, then added the radiator at the top of the cabinet. The radiator comes with three fans, which we have to install first. And the outcome is awesome. It really looks gorgeous. Next, I inserted the graphics card into the motherboard slot and secured it along the cabinet. Then I inserted the hard disk into the dedicated slot. Finally, I took the SMPS. as it is a modular SMPS, so I'll only use the required cables from the bunch. For that, it will be little more convenient. First, I inserted all the cables into the SMPS, then placed the SMPS into the slot and plugged those cables into the motherboard, graphics card and hard disk. After that, I have connected all the ARGB lights and fans into the motherboard. Also connected USB 3.0 and 3.5mm cables of the cabinet front. Now it's time to check if everything is working or not. We got the boot screen, that means everything is working properly. So I installed the OS and done. I really like the look of the cabinet, but few areas are still dark here, especially in these areas. So I took my LED strip box and choose RGB and ARGB LED strip. Cut them in required length and soldered one end with wires and soldered a connector in other end. Like the same, I made few connector cables. After that, I connected them with motherboard and placed those LEDs. And here is before and after. I also connected another RGB LED strip back of the monitor. The color of the LEDs can be changed using RGB fusion. Now let's play the B-roll. Now I can edit 4K videos without any lag, and rendering time is also very less now. The gaming experience is really awesome because of the 2K 144Hz display. Now I can play most of the games in 2K at very high frame rates. Overall, I'm extremely satisfied with the performance of this machine. A quick announcement for you guys. Apart from my DIY YouTube channel, I'm making a new channel for the ones who want to follow me personally. I will be uploading gameplay, vlog and lifestyle related videos on that channel. But I won't be uploading any video until I get 50,000 subscribers on that channel. So click here to subscribe now and see you in my next video. Until then, bye bye.